Good morning, everyone. Dave from the Wee Hours here, back with more Tavern Tycoon in a familiar setting of Pirate Bay of the Blue Seas that we failed on the last time. I failed on the last time. I did not get Pirate Bay of the Blue Seas done, but I am determined. I would really like to get through all of Tavern Tycoon. We're very close. There's only a few more scenarios to go, and I want to see if I can do it. We've had Tavern Tycoon on this channel for ages, and I am determined to finish it. So we are going to start Pirate Bay of the Blue Seas again, hopefully with some lessons learned from the last time. And I think the biggest mistake I made the last time was trying to do too much too quickly and taking on too many people. We had too many dissatisfied guests because I had just way too many people in here. So let's start off. The last time we did Pirate Bay of the Blue Seas, I started off with the mega research department, because what we don't have in this is really any food. We have basically no food. Let me go down to research here. Yeah, we've only got two dishes. Now, they're very good dishes. It's the sausage and eggs and the salad at level 3, but that's it, and our meat quality is terrible. So I am going to do my mega research department again, but with just a little bit of a change up in it. We'll definitely be stalking people in here, but in a slightly different manner than what I did the last time. So give me that, and let's see, let me just zoom out here. Where's going to be... what am I going to do with this place? Door is probably going to live right there. That gives me some room to put some things off to the side. Okay, give me one of those and one of those, and I can already see I should have made my research department bigger. Right, give me that, and can I squeeze one of these in here? Pretty please. No, okay, never mind then. Don't give me that. Don't give me that. Give me another one of these. Can I squeeze that in there? Yes, I can. Yes, I can. Okay, give me that. So it is basically the same mega research department with three ovens. Now, I'm immediately going to hire some people to staff that. I don't have a lot to choose from, though. Okay, anyone coming in with some good research perks? I mean, I've only got four potential candidates here. Wow, these guys are... there we go. That's... I was on the wrong people. You have nimble feet and regeneration. That's fantastic if you were working the floor, but you're not... all right, I've only got four to choose from, so it's basically... I'm going to take the three that don't have perks, and that way I'll put the other one on the floor, because she's got some decent perks for that. So you, not you, you are going to come in here, and you, the other one, come here. You are going to go here. All of you, come here, are only going to do research. So you only do research, and you... only do research. Fantastic. Now I just need one bartender for this. Anyone with the research perks? Apprentice dealer and regeneration? No, no, and no. You're pretty cheap. You're pretty terrible, but you're pretty cheap, and you've got a lot of potential. So you can go there, and you are also just going to do research. Thank you very much. Right, that's stage one of this little endeavor. They're going to crank through research. Now, the only change I wanted to make on research, last time I did it 100% improvement. So, 100% new recipe. Sorry, 100% new recipe. So that they would get more food research, which worked out pretty well. They cranked through some of that. But I was wondering, as I was thinking about it, does that mean the bartender working on the mead quality really isn't doing much? Because he can't make new mead. We don't have any different mead. So I'm just going to back it off just a little bit to say 85-15. So I just, in my mind, the bartender is doing something. He is improving the mead quality. I'll have them drink some potions in just a sec when we get some other things set up here. So let's do... we're going to need bars. We're going to need a kitchen. I think, like last time, most of this area will be restaurant. That's my basic game plan right now. This would actually be a pretty decent area for the staff room while I just happen to be looking at it. Give me the staff room. Let's do that here. Okay. Pop that in there, pop that in there, and then the usual shenanigans, the rug and the little bureau thing here. And if I could tuck maybe two more couches in there, that would be good. Okay. They can hang out in there. Quick trip for everyone working in this building. Now, what do we want to do with bars and kitchens and whatnot? Let's throw the kitchen over here. I threw all of my staff into the research department, so we better be getting a bit of a boost on the old hiring pool sooner rather than later. Let's get that there. The end of my failed Pirate Bay of the Blue Seas, when that was failing, when that was tanking, the biggest problem we had is people were not getting served in the restaurant quickly enough. I was hiring anyone who could stand upright, and we still were not able to serve anyone. So I'm going to plan on a bigger kitchen. Let's get the door right there. That way it'll be centrally located. And we'll get this over here and the little doohickey over here, whatever this thing is. That can live right there. Now, can I get another prep table in here, please? Yes, I can. All right, put that down. Not going to need it right now, but it's good to know I'll have it for later. And we're going to need a bar. So bar, give me that. That can be right up front, sort of right there. You'll walk in the door. You can just peel right over and have a drink. I'm actually going to kick it this way just so I have some room for some benches, because that way people will be a little tiny bit more patient if they have to wait for something. That was our biggest problem. People weren't getting served quickly enough, and they were leaving dissatisfied because they had to wait too long. We'll see if we can also look at some things to offset negative buffs. I don't know what those are yet. I mean, I do. I've been playing Tavern Tycoon for a long time, but we'll see what we can do about offsetting some of that. Right, give me... We're not even open, so give me a bartender. Anyone with some decent perks. Regeneration is always good. You have apprentice dealer. That's nice. We're not going to have the gambling den right away. But yeah, you can work here. You might come in handy later. You can live over there. And why don't you not do research? I don't want you off the floor. Don't go into the research department and cover anyone's breaks. I want you right here all the time. Okay. Fundamentals are down. What I should start doing is some tables. Now, I'm going to try and plan in advance that basically all of this is going to be tables. That's my idea. I would love to put some other stuff down, but right now all of this is going to be tables. Let me have a little bit of a think about how this is all going to come together. So I'm going to start by putting a bunch of tables right by the kitchen door to begin with. And then, can I get that? No, I can't quite get that down there. Then that can live right there and there and there and there. I have one left, but that's good enough for now. That's fine. That's some tables. That allows me to put some rooms over here if I want to, but I'm kind of thinking in advance that's really going to end up being all tables. I'd like to get bar number two down already. We may as well put it down. We know we're going to need it. And I think a great spot for that might be right here-ish. Yeah, I'm digging that. Any other decent bartenders? I mean, I just literally looked at them all, but ooh, you're pricey. You're very overpaid, though. That is good. I like the fact that you're overpaid. You're really cheap, and you're actually somewhat fairly paid. You're in, Sparky. You live there now. And just like your friend over there, don't ever do research. Just leave that to somebody more qualified than you. Okay, how am I doing on money? 48 gold. 48,000 gold, rather. Not 48 gold. That would be terrible. Let's get some things. Ideally, the fireplace would be a good start. Have a think about where I'm going to put... Oh, can I get the fire... I could actually get the fireplace to live right there. I feel that's going to mess with pathing, though. I don't know if that's a good idea. Let's get the fireplace to live sort of here-ish. That will catch a lot of people as they go back and forth. And let's get a stage sort of here-ish. Now, the last time that we did this, I did not jump on the admin's office. I didn't make that a high priority. I think I will this time, largely, once again, for that discount on bards. That is just invaluable. Where can I make this live that it'll catch the most amount of people? Let's try... Actually, you know what? I don't even want this anymore. I want the piano. I don't know why. I just like the piano. There it is. Okay. Ah, this actually seems to have a little bigger radius. Maybe that's why I like this so much. Okay, that can live right there. I like that. Good. Okay. Give me, just while I happen to be thinking about it, give me some more benches and maybe a couple of plants might be a good idea. And a bookshelf. and maybe a swordstone. All right, give me all of this stuff. May as well spend the money I've got. That's a terrible idea. Why did I just say that? But let's throw that. Oh, I don't know. Where could you live? Over, say, there? Yeah, that's pretty good. And you could live maybe over there to catch all the drunk people. You can live there. And where are you going to live? I'd like to kind of get you out of the way if I can. Can you live there and not mess with pathing? Well, we'll soon find out. Okay. Admin's office. Admin's office. I could throw that right in here. I need to put some guest rooms down and a bathroom. But I've got some room for that. I don't have no room for that. Give me... Ugh, I hate wasting the space on the admin's office, but it is really kind of important. Do I have a nice little spot that 4x4 can tuck into? Not really. Okay, just live here then. You can go right there. I'll put some benches or something on the other side, I guess. Go there, do that, and the one thing that lives there, and the cabinet. There we go. All of that can live right there. Done. Super. I've only got the one maiden available for hire because everyone else is doing research, but I'll hire her anyway. I notice she is quite underpaid. Why don't you never do research? And let's bump up your wages a little bit, like, I may as well get you fairly paid just so you're not going to whine about things. You can live right there. I know it's a very large kitchen for one maiden, but it's all going to work out. You're going to have some friends sooner rather than later. Maybe I should just... Yeah, I'm just going to commit to this area being all tables rather than trying to think about some sort of room that might want to live over there. So give me 4 more of those. Let's see if we can get these in here and there and there. Okay, cool. Now, the last time we did Pirate Bay, we tucked the guest rooms into this little corner here, and I think that's still a good idea. It's a nice little spot for them. You can live there, and you can live, I don't know, right there, and there. There's your rug. Now, I don't remember if I could fit 2 or 3 in here. I think it's just 2, but hey, 2's better than 0. Yeah, I will just fit that, unless I have it come out over the edge. There's nothing particularly wrong with that. All right, let me put, I think we'll have 3 guest rooms in here. And that'll be a decent start, at least. People can sleep somewhere. The guest rooms were kind of hit or miss the last time we did it, but I'm going to put them up anyway. People are going to want to sleep somewhere. And the shared guest room. That was pretty important the last time. Now that I'm thinking about guest rooms, people really wanted that shared guest room. All right, lock that in for me. Thank you. Could I get that to live here? And then I still need a bathroom, but I've got some space over here. I don't have no space over here. Actually, I wonder if the shared guest room would work better right here. How big is that? How big is that? Doodly-doodly-doo. Shared guest room, 6x4, but we want that to be super much bigger because those bunk beds take up a ton of space. So if I did that like this and just did one big old shared guest room here, get the door as far away as possible because these bunk beds take up 3 tiles, which is very, very fussy. Give me another bunk bed and another bunk bed and, no surprise, another bunk bed. Now, any chance I can get anyone on the back wall? Yes. Yes, I can. Okay, so this will hold. This room does 10 people, so I need 5 of these. There we go. Cool. Just gonna throw down some more benches just to make sure everyone can be nice and patient while they're waiting for things. Last thing I want to do before we crack the door open is the reception desk. Where does that want to live? I'm having a think about that, but while I'm having a think about it, I may as well throw down a handyman or two. Yeah, you're basically kind of middle of the road. You can live there. We've got earthquakes in this game, in this scenario, so we may as well take that into account by having extra handyman to fix all this stuff. Nobody really showing up with any great perks. That can live right there. And then I'll have a think about getting the staff training room up sooner rather than later. Still need the bathroom. Okay, so restroom. Where does that want to live? Actually, can I get that to live sort of here? That's not the worst place for it. What if we did that like this? That could just, I really need to maximize my space here as best as possible. So let's get that to live there. That can live there. And then how many more of these booths can I fit in here? 3, how about 4? Want to give me one more in there? Perfect. Lock it in. And, of course, the last thing we have to do is name our tavern, which is always the Mulligan. That is just the name of every tavern on this channel ever since, well, the Mulligan. They will all be the Mulligan. Set that name. Thank you very much. I think we are basically ready to open at this point. I think we're good to go. We've got one maiden. Gonna wait as soon as someone else is available for hire. I'll get on that. You guys are all cranking along. That's the important part. And saying that out loud, let's make sure that you're heavily intoxicated while you're doing this. So drink up all the research potions, please. Please do all the research in the world super, super quickly. Although, now that we have the admin's office, we can take trade offers. Actually, do I just want to go ahead and do that right now? Is that a smart move? Admin, what have you got? No trade offers yet. Okay. And I don't think we really need the discount on bards right now because nobody's in the building. But when some trade offers pop up, we'll look at taking those. Armadillo Rat, I got it. Well, the fireworks go off and the Mulligan is open for business. I don't know if I'm going to get much in this area right here, so this might be a good spot for the reception desk. It's as good a spot as any, frankly. So let's pop that guy down there, and then we need an extremely expensive receptionist. Any good perks? Like, you know, the receptionist perk? No, not at all. I really do need that staff training room. You live right there, please. And just do that. You don't have anything else to do anyway. Anyone coming in? Oh yeah, there we go. All right, it's a rogue, I think. No, that's a wizard. I'm sorry, a wizard. Okay, we'll have to start thinking about the old happy rooms around here. I could get something in here. I could get something in here. I'm immediately thinking good spot for an archery range. It's thin and long. And then we've got these other buildings that we can branch out into. This one was fairly cheap. Yeah, that's 3,200. This one, not so much. 12,500. I mean, I almost just kind of want to buy them right now while I've got the money, but no, let's see how things go. Let me figure out what people want before we start throwing down things that we may not need. Well, here's something that somebody's going to need. This guy's got a backpack full of green goo, and that means he wants storage. He wants somewhere to put that. Okay, I can actually take care of that right now. This is as good a spot as any for that. If somebody wants it, I'm willing to put it down. So give me storage, please. It's unreasonably big, in my opinion, but there it is. Storage can live right there, that can go there, and then we need some shelves, and we'll just pop down some more. Better to have more than less, I say. Get one of those there, and then, I don't know, like that. I'm spending way too much money on storage shelves. Fantastic. Lock that in. It is raining. That's no good. Well, no surprise General Dion wants to come by. Yeah, come on over. We spent a ton of money because I just opened the tavern. I'm really going to try to not take every darn reservation that comes down the pike. That was really part of my failing. There's just too many people in the building, and they just weren't getting served quickly enough. Good. Somebody else coming in with some storage items. That's great. We can accommodate that. Receptionist doesn't really have a lot to do right now, but it's not like I'm not going to need her at some point. And you guys, are you drinking heavily? I noticed your potions have worn off. Hang on. Let me make sure you're heavily intoxicated while you're researching stuff. Thank you very much. Well, good. This guy's going to be happy that we've got the storage. He's heading over there to put his backpack full of green goo in storage. Is that a biohazard, sir? Should you be more careful with that? I'm not really sure I want that on the property, to be honest. What's in the mail? A new menu item. Oh, fantastic, guys. Well done, research department. We now know how chickens work. Excellent. Good. Are you still intoxicated? Yes, you are. Good. Well, that's going to help. Keep drinking heavily, folks. And there are some new maidens available for hire. I'm going to see if there's anyone good in here that I could grab. Wow, you're dirt cheap and overpaid. I mean, you're terrible. But, you know, you'll grow over time. Anyone coming on with some good perks? Regeneration, that's always good. That's excellent. Ah, nimble feet and regeneration, and you're overpaid, and you're not completely hideously expensive. Fantastic. You are on board. You work in the kitchen now, and P.S. Don't do research. Don't ever do that. What do we got in the mail? A group reservation of locals. How many? 9. No, not right now. Let's be a little more cautious on accepting the reservations. I don't really know that we're equipped to deal with 9 people. I see you, kids. I will take your 15 rep. Thank you very much. I don't think we're really equipped to deal with a lot of reservations right now, especially where we don't have the happy rooms. I'm going to be a little more cautious about accepting reservations and not accepting tons of them, even when we have all the happy rooms in place, because that's where I failed. Just tanked this on too many people in the building. Speaking of happy rooms, let's make sure we change some policies here for the rooms that we don't actually have yet. So if you guys are looking for the archery range or the express shop and you don't see it, I would prefer you actually just left. Just go away, because we're not going to have it right away. And I also see our research department is sober. That is unacceptable. Keep drinking things, please. Thank you. What popped up in the mail? Interested in quality of Garvine. No. Wait. Do I want this? No, not for 2,500 gold. I don't know what that is. I'm not doing that. Well, General Dion largely hated us, but he gave us 25 rep and some potions, so that's very good. Research department, are you intoxicated? Yes, you are. Good, good. I want you completely hammered while you do research in there. I'm sure that's not dangerous at all, working on an open stove while you're heavily, heavily inebriated. I'm sure it's all fine. Oh, more mail. Is it research department? Please say yes, no. It's group reservation of rogues. Yeah, 9 rogues. We have no capacity to deal with that. We have no archery range. Monthly report, we spent a ton of money, I'm sure. We have no archery range, so we can't really deal with the rogue issue. Although, that was one of the first things that we put up over here. Do I want to spend 3,200 gold on an archery range? And that would be one happy room that we can kind of lock down. Now, you left with a minus 30. Mead is terrible, yes. Cranberry pie, not available. I hear you, man. I hear you. Not much I can do about that right now. Is there any trade offers that have come in? Nope, not yet. Could get that discount on bards, but I don't know that we have the population where that's necessary at the moment. People are getting served. We have no real food. And we certainly don't have food that people want, but people are getting served in what I believe is a timely manner. What? What do you want? A group reservation of whatevers? No. No, thank you very much. I see you, knight. I'll take your 15 rep. Thank you very much. Our rep is not great. Not great. This could end sooner than I think. There's that group reservation of rogues. I kind of want to put up... Maybe I should just spend the money now. You know what? It's not like I'm not going to buy that at some point. I may as well spend the money now, and then I can at least get one happy room locked down. I could build an awesome archery range here, too. I could build a really, really good one. So let's go ahead and build the archery range. Let's get that to go all the way down there. Oh, they're going to love this. This is going to be like the world's best archery range, and I'll definitely have them walk through the path of fire when they come in. That can live over there. That can live way down there. That's actually a pretty challenging archery range, and that can go there, and some more targets, please. Again, I have no idea if adding the extra targets does anything. It just satisfies my aesthetic on it. There we go. Archery range in play, and let me make sure that I change that to... wait for the archery range. Yes, you can wait for the archery range. It's really good right now. And now I'm going to take a chance. I see you, kids. I got you. I'm going to take a chance on accepting those rogues, because we have a really, really good archery range. It's 9 of them. That's a lot, but I'm going to give it a shot, see how that plays out. Now I've got to kind of chill on the money. Now we basically have no money. Armadillo rat, I got it. There's 10 gold right there. Hey, research department, you want a drink? Have a drink. Oh, we've got some trade offers. Okay, what do I want out of this? Cranberry pie, 13 of them for 832 gold. And that's... yeah, you've got 11 for 990. No, I'll take... wow, that's a lot of money. I'm going to take it anyway. I don't generally do those trade offers, but... I gotta try and keep people as happy as is humanly possible here, and now I've got some cranberry pie. So if someone comes in for cranberry pie, we have a limited amount. Oh, thank you, research department. Oh, you just researched cranberry pie. Thanks. Now you're leaving sad. What was your problem? No rabbit stew and the arcane study wasn't open. I know, there's only so much I can build at any one point, Mr. Wizard Sir, although, that being said, out loud, in my voice, I could start to work on the arcane study, although I'm hemorrhaging money at this point. Lord General Dion wants to come over, sure, absolutely, and we've spent a ton of money. Thank you very much. I think this may be a scenario where I have to look at a loan. I hate loans. I hate taking out loans in any sort of tycoon or building game because I'm just not very good at paying them back, and it usually leads to bankruptcy. But I might have to do that. I might have to do that. That way I could get another happy room up sooner rather than later. Let me just see what our finances look like next month and see how viable putting the wizard's study up might be. Oh, goody, it's an earthquake. Now, earthquake or not, you're leaving actually somewhat happy. You didn't like the mead and there was no gym, but it was warm, you got hit with the fireplace, you had a good meal, and you use the shared guest room. Okay, so we can start to offset some of the negatives with some positives. Shared guest room is getting some action. That's good. I mean, it's not a huge modifier. It's just a plus one, but you know what? It's better than them having a negative for not having the shared guest room. And there's even someone in the regular guest room, too. Cool. You've got a pig on your back. Probably don't store that pig near the green goo. I can't feel that's going to end well. General Dion's going over to check out the archery range. It's awesome. It's not really going to work out so well with your mammoth hammer here, but it's really, really good. I notice absolutely none of the rogues I just got in here are taking advantage of that, but that's because they're all up at the bar getting drunk. Speaking of getting drunk, research department. I notice you're not intoxicated. That's your last red potion, so use it wisely. I see you, kids. I got you. I want your 15 rep very, very badly. We are... Well, let me see what the wages are like. I'm actually going to speed it up just a tiny little bit here. Tiny little bit is the only option I have in terms of speed. Oh, hang on. I see you. I got you. This is why I don't like doing it in fast-forward mode. There are things in Tavern Tycoon I need to react to, and that's 15 rep right there. That ain't nothing. 15 rep can be critical when this is a reputation-based game. So that's why I don't often do this in fast-forward mode, because there are things I need to deal with around here. But let me just see if I can just get to the end of the month. I want to see how badly our money's going to be after we pay our wages, and I really think we need another handyman. There's a lot of vomit on the floor. Okay, we survived the month just fine. I am going to put another handyman on. There's no question of that. So give me... Anyone got some decent perks in here? You've got regeneration. You're grossly underpaid, though. I'm going to have to boost your wages. Speaking of wages, I should actually go through the wages. You have nimble feet and regeneration, and you're overpaid. Very good. I like you. Let me just check out... Hang on. Pause it a sec there, Tavern Tycoon. Let me just check out the whole staff situation here. Yeah, everyone is basically happy working for me. You, not quite as much. You're quite overpaid, though. I'm just going to give you a couple of bonuses rather than a raise, because you're already overpaid. So that's fine. You could just have a little pocket change, and hopefully you'll keep working for me. My other thought was the arcane study. Right, the arcane study. Where would be a decent spot for that? Can I squeeze a really good one sort of here? What's the numbers on that? Arcane study 6x4. Do I have 4 there? 1, 2, 3, 4. I sure do. So let's get this. Let's just have an amazing arcane study. Actually, mate, does it need to be that big? What I want to do is get 2 of the little chessboard areas and at least a couple of desks. You know what? Do it. If I do a really, really big one now, maybe I won't need to do a second one later. So, Nope, I can get that in there. Okay, and this can live here, and we can have a study desk here, and come on, go over there. There. This is going to cost me a fortune, absolute fortune, but there it is. There it is. And we've got the rest of the month to make up that money. And let me just quickly go over to policy and make sure that people can get in there. So yes, now you can wait for the arcane study. research department coming through again. We have rabbit stew on the menu. General Dion didn't hate us as much as last month, and monthly report, we've spent a ton of money. I'm not going to take any of these reservations right now. I'd rather spend my money on making sure the people that we have here already are satisfied. That's kind of my game plan here, and you can have a bookshelf too. I really can't afford to be spending this money, but I want to make sure if any rogues come over here, they've got somewhere to sit down while they're waiting to use the archery range, which I'm going to assume they basically love. Amazing archery range, plus 18, fantastic. That's great, and that more than offset his little complaint about the mead. He loved the garden salad. Plus 45 on the garden salad. That is great. And those fireplaces, they just pay for themselves in reputation. Every time you walk by it, that's a plus 11 right there. I see you, kids. I've got you. That is probably a good place to call it on Tavern Tycoon for today. Back with Pirate Bay of the Blue Seas. I am determined to get through the Tavern Tycoon scenario, so I'm taking another bash at Pirate Bay of the Blue Seas, hopefully with some lessons learned from the last one. But as always, if you've got ideas, if you've got tips, do let me know in the comments section below. And hey, if you enjoyed the video, do please leave a like down below. It does cheer me up no end when people do that. And if you're new to the channel, maybe just checking it out for the first time, feel free to hit that subscribe button. I got you. See more of this ridiculous nonsense? Until then, I'm Dave. Thank you, as always, for joining me in the wee hours, and we'll see you. I got you, too! Next time.
Don't even try.
Robot, how do we rescue you? I don't know how to rescue you. I'm also not sure I ever knew you were a woman. Bugs are inherently stupid, and they get in places and they can't get out. You know what places they get in? Things that are wide open that don't have screens over them! It's a piece of mesh! We figured this out like 100 years ago. What is wrong with the British, the Irish?
Is it just a show about foxes all the time? If so, is that some sort of subtle esoteric thing about being a weapons manufacturer, or is it just stuck on the Nature Channel?